Hello and welcome to AzureWala YouTube channel. We are in part 43 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 75 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 76. You have an Azure Active Directory tenant. You plan to delete multiple users by using bulk delete in Azure Active Directory Admin Center. You need to create and upload a file for the bulk delete. Which user attributes should you include in the file? Let's quickly see the bulk delete template which we have downloaded and what are the required fields in it. There are three operations or user operations available in Azure Active Directory to manage the users or multiple users. So first one is bulk delete operation is there. Second is bulk create Active Directory users, and third one is bulk invite. So let's understand the bulk delete, where we need to provide a username, or in technical wording user principal name. This is the required field. This is the only field we need to delete any user from the Active Directory. So this answers our question that we just need the user principal name. Therefore you may see three possible questions in exam. So first possibility is that it may ask that what required field you need when you do the bulk delete, or when you perform the bulk delete operation. In that case, user principal name, that keep in mind. Question number two, you may see that when we bulk create Active Directory users, what are the mandatory fields we need, or required fields we need. In that case, we need a display name, we need a principal name, we need the password, and we need the block sign in. So these four fields are required in this case. And the third question may appear is that when we bulk invite the users, in that case, what do we need? We need the invitee email address and a redirection URL. These two fields only we need. Here we have prepared for three possible questions which may appear in exam. So keep in mind. Let's move to next question. Back to our question, that which attribute for bulk delete we need here. So which option is correct? In this case, option B is correct, because we just need user principal name. That is enough for each and every user. So option A says here that user principal name and usage location of each user. No, we don't need usage location. We just need principal name, user principal name. The option C is the display name for each user only. No, we don't need display name in this case. The display name and usage location, definitely not. We just need user principal name. And option E is that the display name and user principal name for each user. No. So option B is correct. Let's move to next question. Question 77. You have three offices and an Azure subscription that contains an Azure Active Directory tenant. You need to grant user management permissions to local administrator in each office. What should you do? The scenario here is that we do have two different offices. So for example, this is the one office, this is the second office. Let's say we give one and we give two, and we do have one user or some users here, 1, 2, 3 users here and 4 and 5 here, for example. Then someone we need to manage this user, so act as administrator for this user, and someone else is the administrator for this user. So this is how we would like to manage. So that person, the admin of this location, will not be able to access here, and admin of this location will not be able to access here. So this is how the separation we would like to have. So local administrator. Okay, now the first answer or option A is Azure Active Directory role. Azure Active Directory roles are used to manage Azure Active Directory resources in a directory, we cannot have segregation on that. So we cannot separate the resources. Therefore, this will not be applicable in this case. Option B is administrative units. An administrative units is a Azure directory resource that can be a container for other Azure Active Directory resources. An administrative unit can contain only users, groups, and devices. Therefore, this is the correct answer. So we can assume as one unit this one, or administrative unit, and the second one is this administrative unit, and we can separate and we can contain users or groups or devices in it, and then we can manage the the permissions over it through the admin. So we can manage these users, we can manage these devices. Administrative units are similar to Active Directory Domain Service Organization units previously we used to have. So on-premise, if we do have, we have organizational units. It is the similar concept in Azure. So this is the correct answer. And also for having the administrative unit in place, we require P1 or Premium 1 license for that purpose, for the admin only, and the unit members are free in this case. Option C, let's see the option C, what it is. And option C is access packages in Azure Active Directory entitlement management. Entitlement management in Active Directory is an identity governance feature that enables organization to manage identity and access lifecycle. So definitely we are not looking for access lifecycle here. Option D is Azure Roles. Azure Role is an authorization system built in Azure Resource Manager that provides fine-grained access management to the Azure resources. Therefore, this is also not applicable here. We can visualize the administrative unit for the organization is like this, that for example, we do have different business units where, let's say, a School of Business is separate, a School of Engineering is separate, and security team and executive teams are separate, and we would like to assign someone as a user administrator, a group admin, license admin, and help desk admin for that particular business unit. So we can have separation of help desk and group admin and user admin role for each business unit, and we can apply that on a particular business unit. So this is how the administrative unit works here. And let's see on the Azure portal as well. We are in Azure portal now. We'll go to Active Directory. Under the Active Directory, we can see administrative unit, and we can add here new administrative unit, and this looks, and we can assign the role and review and create. So we can create administrative unit from here. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and press bell notification icon. Share with your friends. Thank you for watching. See you in next video.